This magic moment.
As we go along. work. Ah, no, I don't think you can dance. Well, man, come with me.
We've got magic to do just for you. We've got miracle plays to play. We've got parts to perform, parts to warn. Kings and queens to take by storm. As we go along, we've got magic to do. 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 We've got magic to do.
Here, please. Oh, it's a hot day out here. Ladies and gentlemen, this evening, for your entertainment pleasure, we present our most mysterious and miraculous tale, a stunning example of
magic.
You will witness acts of
murder,
holy war,
and a climax, ladies and gentlemen. A climax you'll remember for the rest of your lives. Ha! Not now, Leo. What a pandemic will do to you. Our tale today concerns the firstborn son of Charlemagne and is entitled Pippin, His Life in Times. But before we begin, there have been many misconceptions about Pippin. One that he was... That he was
enormously tall.
That he was
extremely short.
Or that he was
completely bald by the age of 14.
But I beg you, cast all previous misconceptions aside. Our tale today begins as Pippin's childhood ends.
His last day at the University of Padua, where his father had sent him.
So that he might embark upon his life with a maximum of choices.
And possibilities.
Pippin so distinguished himself at university that the faculty bestowed upon him the special title of...
Scholar of the House!
And Pippin responded in his own deeply moving words. He may be a little nervous. After all, this is his first time playing the role.
Could I have some more lights, please?
Well, I guess he's not that nervous.
Thank you. Gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty, I'm very grateful for the knowledge you've given me, but I'm afraid what I'm looking for just can't be found in books.
And Pippin made a promise.
I promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits. I'm going to live a life that's extraordinary. I know there is something. I just can't quite find the word for it.
Something fulfilling. Something completely fulfilling.
Yes, that's it. Something completely fulfilling. And I'm going to find it. I'm not exactly sure what I want to do. Or where I want to go. But everything has its season. Everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. So why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner. Is cool. People like the way dreams have of sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning, nightingales have their song. And don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. destined to settle for something small. But I won't rest until I know I'll have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
Ourselves a live one. Doodly-doo, journey to a spot exciting, mystic and exotic, journey through our anecdotic review, the royal court of Charles the Great. Enter Charlemagne!
This part is to be portrayed by an actor of enormous power.
Power.
We join Charlemagne in the midst of his royal court. It's been a long day.
And that is why, sire, I humbly beseech you to reduce my
levy. Denied. Next.
Sire, come on.
Oh, great leader, blessed by God, sent to us from heaven.
Oh, my God, not this bullshit again. What do you want?
Sire, due to a famine, my fields are barren. I ask
denied
you to...
Denied next.
Sire!
Denied.
Sire,
denied.
That's unjust and tyrannical.
Take that man out and hang him!
That's sire! Sire!
All of you get out! Out!
Father!
I said everybody out!
Father, it's me!
Out!
Pippin!
Pippin?
Pippin! It is good to see you!
What are you doing here?
I'm home. I finished school.
Already? Well, how did it go?
Oh, very well, Father. Some
good,
of my tutors
good,
even...
Good, good, good. You know, I've always been a great believer in education.
And yet you've become the most powerful man in the world without it.
Pippin, the most powerful man in the world?
Oh.
What about the Pope?
I rank you ahead of the Pope, sir.
I happen to agree with you! Well, Pippin, good seeing you.
But Father!
You know what? We have a library now. Maybe get yourself a book, I don't know.
Well, thank you, but...
After all, tomorrow is for you.
But it's still today.
Yes, but for how long? You see, Pippin, sunrise and sunset are similar, yes, yes. But they're not identical. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Father, what does that even mean?
Enter Louis! Pippin's half-brother, and after Pippin, heir to the throne. Addicted to the physical, Louis loves...
Take it.
Weightlifting. Louis loves... wrestling. But most importantly, Louis loves...
Louis.
Ha! Visigoths!
Well done, brother.
Of course it was. Did you know that this arm slew 20 Frisians last year? It's going to slay even more Visigoths!
You're going to war against the Visigoths?
That's the next one. It's going to be a glorious campaign. And oh, those Visigoth women! I don't mean to shock your bookish sensibilities.
I'm only shocked you're interested in women now.
Enter Fasrada. Pippin's... crafty. Cunning. Calculating.
But a warm and wonderful mother.
Dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Louis.
Louis, guess what Mummy had made for you? Surprise!
Oh, thank you, Mother. Think how I'll shine. Look at this. Isn't it a beauty?
It really is beautiful.
Of course it's beautiful. Lewis is a great warrior.
Ha! Visigoths!
We're so proud of Lewis, aren't we, my dear? Oh, my darling, before I forget, the royal treasurer's informed me I've somehow overdrawn my allowance account.
You're overdrawn again?
Now, my lord. You know how confused I get about the money. After all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother. Just like all you housewives and mothers out there.
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is really worth the fornicating I'm getting. This guy gets me, right? Quarantined with her for like 15 months? I don't know how you do it.
Father!
Oh God, you're still here! What? What do you want?
I know what I want to do now.
Oh, good, good, good.
I want to be a soldier!
Oh, you're serious? Denied.
Father, I'm your oldest son. That means I'll be king one day. And fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Oh! Mm-mm-mm. Fighting wars is the most important part of being king. After all, the Pope and I have dedicated ourselves to spreading Christianity across the entire world. Even if you have to kill all the non-Christians to do it.
Exactly. So I want to join in your campaign against the Visigoths.
Deny.
But that's not fair. You're taking Lewis.
Your brother Lewis is an ideal warrior. He is strong and stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
And for what? Father, you're dedicated to something. And I just want to be dedicated to something too, with all my heart and soul. Something extraordinary. Otherwise, my life won't have any meaning.
You want your life to have meaning, do you?
Yes, I do.
That's very ambitious of you, Pippin. Deny.
But Father!
Deny, Father,
you created an entire kingdom out of nothing. And now I just want my chance. My chance to fight for my country, for my family, and for my king.
All right, fine. Get yourself a decent helmet and come along.
I'm a soldier.
Yes, you are.
Me, a warrior. Finally, a chance to do something important. A chance to use my sword, my arm, and maybe even my blood.
Gentlemen, be seated. Map. Now, the main factor in tomorrow's battle against the Visigoths.
Ha! Visigoths!
Is the terrain. So look at this map. Study it. Remember it.
Father, if we're braver and stronger than they are, and have God on our side, why can't we just go up there?
War is a science which a general must use, with stratagems and strategies, statistical analyses, to know how many soldiers he's prepared to lose.
Yeah!
Now, gentlemen, listen up. This is the plan for tomorrow's skirmish. The army of the enemy is stationed on a hill, so we've got to get them down here where they're easier to kill. So you and Nerafine, that's this area in green, will move across the plain where you plainly can be seen. Then the enemy in blue will undoubtedly pursue. We'll hope to keep your losses to comparatively few. And then
the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Hark, the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilations, we can hear a grateful nation.
Everyone, sit down immediately! Alright, where was I? Useless. Anyone? Anyone at all? No, why would you? Why would you? How about you? Yes. A
general accepts that war is hell or even worse. He must never be too cautious or casualty averse. I'm certain the majority of blood that you will splatter will be theirs, but just the minimum of damage that's collateral. We all know for success, we must always pay a price. That's why for my success, you must sacrifice. And then, and gentlemen, and then.
And then the men go marching. I'm sorry, Father.
Yeah, I don't want to hear it. Because I'm time short, I gotta speed the whole damn thing up.
General, I have to explain what separates a charlatan from a Charlemagne. Oh, that's all my generals, illustrious and various. A pompous as a poppy, and daring as a Darius. A little rule that every leader knows by heart. It's smarter to be lucky than it's lucky to be smart. And then, and gentlemen, and then.
He's over there.
No, Pippin, no!
I just can't keep working with these amateurs. I can't do it.
And then the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. And our blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilations, we can hear a grateful nation.
Lewis, Pippin, it's time.
I'm going to make you very proud once again, Father.
I will try not to disgrace you, sir.
Follow me. I really can't leave today.
Battles, barbarous and bloody. Glory, glory. Glory, glory.
Praise be to Charles our Lord. Triumphant is his sword. Allegiance is his word. Glory, glory. Glory, glory. Warmer than wine, the taste of salty summer brine. Steel!
Steel!
Huh. Steel is cold as moonlight.
Huh.
Steel is sharper than sight. Sharper than sight. Touch of bitter winter wine.
Shout it up from the highest tower. Shout it up in the darkest hour. Charlemagne, you lead us on to power.
War!
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 You ain't seen nothing yet, folks.
It's required.
And singing is essential to victory.
You're not joining in?
All right. Go to, men. Let's give thanks to God for granting us this glorious victory.
Late, but because you're interested, I'm just a common man, a Visigoth, but a good man, a very good man. You're also a very lucky man. You've had the privilege of dying for your king.
Words fail me.
You know, of course, dying in battle like this, you'll be going straight to Valhalla.
Oh, absolutely. The king has assured us personally. Though, all this waiting around's got me feeling a bit, edgy.
This wasn't your first battle, was it?
No, my, Third.
Well, then maybe you could tell me. How did this battle compare with your other two?
Well, unless you get killed, one battle's pretty much like another.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Pippin, where are you?
I hope you get to Valhalla soon.
Hope you get to heaven.
Oh, I will.
Pippin, this is embarrassing! A victory celebration and my own son not joining in!
Sorry, Father. You'll have to get used to victory celebrations without me. I thought there'd be more plumes.
Damn the squads, though.
Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free.
Well, I'll sing you the story of a sorrowful lad. He had everything he wanted, didn't want what he had. He had wealth and pomp and felt the name and all of that noise. But he didn't have none of those simple joys. His life seemed purposeless and flat. Aren't you glad you don't feel like that? So he ran from all the deeds he'd done. He ran from things he'd just begun. He ran from himself, which is mighty far to run. Out into the country where he played as a boy. For he knew he had to find him some simple joys. He wanted someplace warm and green. We all could use a change of scene. Sweet summer evenings, hot wine and bread. Sharing your bed. Simple joys have a simple voice. It says, why not go ahead? And wouldn't you rather be a left-handed flea or a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea than a man who never learned how to be free? Not till he's cold and dead. Wouldn't you rather be a left-handed flea or a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea or a newt on the root of a banyan tree than a man who never learns how to be free? Not till he's cold and dead. Sweet summer evenings, sapphire sky, feasting your belly, feasting your eyes. Simple joys have a simple voice. Pride. And wouldn't you rather be a left-handed flea or a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea or a newt on the root of a banyan tree or a fig on a twin galley? Man, a man who never learns how to be free, not till the day he the day, he not to the day, not to the day. He dies.
Enter Bertha,
Pippin's grandmother. Living in the country.
I can walk by myself.
Warm, strong.
Very attractive.
Exiled from court.
Due to a personality conflict with her daughter-in-law.
This dreaded.
Grandma?
I hate needlepoint.
How about you're so good at it?
Pippin? Oh, Pippin, I can't believe it. Oh, how good it is to see you and to hold you the way I used to.
Grandma, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
No, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
Fine, you look terrible.
Is that any way to speak to your grandma? Ooh. But actually, Pippin, you look terrible. You need some fresh air, some good food, some hanky-panky.
I don't know what I need.
Ooh, I know what I need. Some good juicy gossip. You gotta tell me what's been going on at court. Is Fischeretta still leading your father around by the nose?
Grandma, you haven't changed a bit.
Oh, but you have, Pippin. What have you been doing with yourself?
Well, I went to war.
That explains it.
I tried to own my own manhood, you know? Give my blood back. I wanted to do something important, something meaningful. But that wasn't it. Now I just feel empty and vacant. So I think I need a plan. Yes, that's it. A goal and a plan. Well, I have a goal. I want to be fulfilled. But a good plan? That's what I've been thinking about. Because you can't just go rushing into the next thing and hope for the best. But on the other hand, you can't just wait for something to fall into your lap.
Stop thinking. You think too much. That's your problem. You need to learn to live in the moment. Look at this day. Look at it. The sun is shining. The air is warm. And maybe tonight, down at the tavern, there's that lovely young girl you could hook up with and do all those things you kids do. Then come back here and tell me everything in graphic detail.
Grandma, I don't have time for that.
Time? Now, Pippin, you listen to me. I'm an expert on time. When you are as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you will woefully wonder why, my dear, through your cataracts and catarrh, you will squander away or sequester the drops of a precious year. For when your best days are yester, with the weeds, or a succulent bear, and with each juicy bite, you spit out your teeth with the seeds. Before it's too late, stop trying to wait for fortune and fame you're secure of. For there's one thing to be sure of, mate, there is nothing to be sure of. Oh, it's time to start living, time to take a little from the
about.
Now you sit down. Don't say anything until I finish. I have three more choruses to do. But you can join in with me if you wish. And that goes for all of you too. All of you out there staring at me, looking dumbfounded. If you go to the stepknock.org website, the playbill will be there. And if you scroll down to where all the songs are, the lyrics should be right there. So if you want to join in. But just the choruses, the verses are all mine. Piece of cake. Now chance to raise some hell. Everybody, oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world we're given. Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall. In just no time at all. Sages tweet that age is sweet. Good deeds and good work earn you laurels. But what could make you feel more obsolete than being noted for your morals? Give me a man who is handsome and strong, someone who's stalwart and steady. Give me a night that's romantic and long, but give me a month to get ready. Now I may waylay some aging roué and persuade him to play in some cranny, but it's hard to believe I'm being led astray by a man who calls me granny. All right, this time let's hear from everybody. 1, 2, 3.
Absolutely right. It's time for me to start living. Maybe that's the secret to life. Just live in the moment. Enjoy the simple things. The fresh air. The cool, clean water. The fresh fruit off of the... Oh, yes. And women.
Sex presented pastorally.
Of course, women.
My days are brighter than morning air. Evergreen pine and autumn blue. But all my days were twice as fair. If I could share my days with you.
Excuse me.
My nights are warmer than fire coals. Incense.
I found it!
You really frolic, don't you? Well, how do you feel now?
I just feel empty and vacant.
I don't know. What you were doing back there looked like fun to me.
But it wasn't fulfilling. Why can't I find something completely fulfilling?
Look, you just got started. There's a whole lot of things you could try.
Like what?
Like taking a look at this.
Peasants revolt. King slays thousands. Peasants protesting a rise in new taxes were slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne's soldiers. What? That can't be true.
Now, would a newspaper print anything that isn't true?
My father would never slaughter people just for protesting.
Why not? He's the king. Today, Charles has given orders that non-believers be given the choice between baptism and beheading.
Wait a minute. Forcing people to believe? Telling them what to think? Something's gotta be done about this.
You're absolutely right.
You know, I'm finally beginning to see who my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that doesn't even belong to them.
He does.
Well, I think this has got to stop.
It has got to stop.
It's time for a change.
Damn it, it's time for a change.
You know, it doesn't even matter that he's my father. We can't just wait around for someone else to take action. Otherwise, one day we'll ask what happened. What happened is that we failed to act.
Testing, testing.
It's time to create a better world for all people, not just the rich and powerful. This tyrant must be overthrown. Terror and bloodshed must be ended. We need a leader with the youth and courage to sweep out the old order. Down with Charles. Up with me.
Revolution!
Terrible. A son speaking against his very own father that way. In fear of my beloved husband's life. I brought Pippin's activities to his attention. Pippin is disloyal to you, my lord!
Every son is disloyal to his father at one point or another.
But Lewis loves you, my lord!
Lewis is an asshole, my lady.
Despite this rejection, I took upon my tiny shoulders the task of effecting a rapprochement for two men for whom I felt deeply. Back in my younger days, if things were going wrong, I might sulk, I might pout. Now I've learned if I just pitch in and do what's right, things will always work out. And if we all could spread a little sunshine on fire, we all would be a little closer to our heart's desire, my lord.
Yes, my lady.
But you'll be praying at Arles next month.
No, I don't think so, my lady.
But you always feel so much better after your yearly prayer.
I do.
Yes, you do.
I sought out Pippin. Your father loves you, Pippin.
Freedom and dignity for all men is more important than the love between one father and one son.
Still, your name will be on his lips when he prays at Arles. Next month, alone.
Alone?
And unguarded.
What date?
The 15th. Pippin, I beg of you to bring this estrangement to an end.
Oh, I intend to.
No. May I tell your father of this resolve?
No. Let it be a surprise.
A surprise? I love surprises!
Mama, what if Pippin kills father?
You'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
Mama, what if Pippin discovers the king's plot and executes him?
You'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
No matter what happens, Mama, I'll move up.
Yes, darling. I know the parables told in the holy books I keep close on my shelf. God's wisdom teaches me when I help others, I'm really helping myself. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could lend a helping hand, we all would be a little closer.
Safe travels, Father.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, my lord. Oh, my. Events move so swiftly. It's hard for a simple woman like me to keep up. But something tells me that one day soon, I'll be able to say what every mother wishes to say. My son, the king. Ordinary housewife and mother. Just like all you housewives and mothers out there!
Intrigue plots to bring disaster. The Royal Chapel at Arles.
It's all right, Father. You may come in.
Sorry to disturb you, my son. I know you like to pray alone.
You know who I am, Father?
Of course, my son.
Well, then you need something from me, perhaps. Favor? Advancement?
I'm here to be with you for one moment. To look into your eyes.
And what is it that you see?
I see two eyes. A little cloudy with age. A sunset.
What else?
I see the death of thousands. The enslavement of more. Terror and bloodshed.
You see all that in my eyes.
Do you deny it?
Deny it. I'm proud of it. I brought order out of chaos. If terror and bloodshed were necessary to achieve that order, so be it.
Those are words from the past. Time has passed you by, my son.
And your time has come, my son.
Yes, father.
It's so easy from where you stand to judge the things I've done. Eagles, ospreys, even vultures had a better view. From the heights, all things are very clear. But when I marched, the dust of the road was in my mouth. And when I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eyes. But by God, I blew my breath across a continent and I shaped an empire with it.
Father, maybe you did the best you could, but things have to change.
And you're the one to change them?
Yes, I am!
Well, if you truly believe that, there's only one thing left for you to do.
Thank you, but I brought my own.
Then use it, or go and leave me to my prayers.
Father, what do you pray for?
Strength. And may God give you...
I want my hands to stop shaking. When all the earth is still, when ancient ghosts are awaking, if so many steps need taking, so many plans need making, I think I will. I think I will.
Your Majesty.
King Pippin.
Your Highness, King Pippin.
Morning glow, morning glow, starts to glimmer when you know. Winds of change are set to blow and sweep this whole land through. Morning glow is long past due.
Old faith looking names.
take a little break here. After all, attention spans are shorter than they used to be. Thank you, you two. But we'll be back with the finale we promised. A climax you'll remember for the rest of your lives.
Morning glow.
So hard on all my life. Is that fair?
No, that's completely unfair. But I will do something about it. I hereby decree that from now on, all peasants shall own the land they cultivate.
King Pippin, the just!
Sire, now that you have given our land to the peasants, we loyal nobles have no source of income. Therefore, we can no longer pay taxes.
Well, then, I abolish taxes.
King Pippin, the generous!
You realize, sire, that without taxes, you won't have enough money to support an army.
That's all right. I don't need an army. No more taxes, no more army!
King Pippin, the peaceful.
Hey, Pippin. Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the infidel Hun has attacked in the east. He has destroyed 3 of your villages and murdered thousands of your royal subjects.
Can he do that?
But he will withdraw on one condition.
Oh, that's very reasonable. What's the condition?
He demands your reproductive organs on a pike staff.
Well, in that case, I guess we'll just have to go out and destroy the infidel!
Yeah!
We don't have an army.
Good point. Excuse me a moment. Noble.
Yes, sire?
Do you remember that decree I made a little while ago about land and taxes?
Yes, sire.
Well, that's off.
But sire, without land, I have neither money nor power over the peasants.
Oh, right. Peasant.
Yes, sire?
I hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform? You mean give it back?
That's right, give it back.
Unsigned, sire!
Take that woman away and hang her! No, stop, stop. Let me think for a minute, please.
Darling, you're a born ruler. You're doing a wonderful job. Now, about my royal allowance.
Deny.
Deny.
Deny, deny, deny!
King Pippin, the unpopular.
I need to pray.
Pray? You are the king. What in the world would you pray for?
Strength.
Is there anything else you'd like?
Yeah, I'd like my knife back.
You want it? You got it.
Illusion, fantasy to study.
Sorry, Father.
Well, that's all right, son. Just don't let it happen again.
Well, that didn't turn out the way I thought it would. I still haven't done anything fulfilling with my life.
But you will, Pippin, you will. You may not believe this, but things are going exactly according to plan.
They are?
You look frenzied, you look frazzled, peaked as any alp, flushed and rushed and razzle-dazzled. Dry your lips, damp your scalp, now I can see you're in a rut in disarray, and I'm not one. But in fact, I must say, if you take it easy, trust a while, don't look blue, don't look back, you'll pull through in just a while, 'cause you're on the right track,
on the right track.
Keep those
hopes soft.
Keep cool as custard.
Trying hard,
stepping soft.
There's no trick to staying sensible despite each cul-de-sac, 'cause each step's indispensable when you're on the right track.
On the right track. On the right track. On the right track. On the right track.
Into life with his usual zest. He tried art, the creative life, and you know something? He wasn't too bad. What he discovered was...
The king makes budget cuts. The arts are definitely the first to go.
He tried the church, the religious life. He longed to be touched by an angel. But what he discovered was...
It wasn't an angel that touched me.
When things get dank, we feel their grip. Go, we stay tranquil, spirits high, pulses low.
But what I've left behind looks trifling. What's ahead looks black. Am I doomed? going on.
Just we going on, alright.
We'll never find it. Never, never, never. Shit.
Easy, baby. You're on the right
track. Enter Catherine. Enter Catherine.
Sorry. I just couldn't get my eyelash on you.
How many years have you been playing this role for?
Sorry.
Okay. We'll just do it again.
Okay.
Get out of my face. Enter Catherine, a lovely young widow. A lovely widow.
When I first saw Pippin, he was lying on the side of the road. He didn't know where he was. And he looked so exhausted and lost-ed. The man had obviously lost his will to live. So the first thing I had to do was get him interested in something. Something to restore his faith in life. Something like, me. So I said, pick him up, put him to bed, see that he's bathed and clothed and fed. You may ask, how could I foretell? It cleared up, oh, so very well. But it was no surprise when I raised my eyes, and there he was. Well, I'm sure there are many things you'd like to know about me, aren't there?
No.
Good, my name is Catherine. I'm a widow. I have a son. This is my estate. I'm your average, ordinary kind of woman. Competent and neat. Making life a treat. Customary kind woman, practical adult, modest to a fault, conservative with a budget, liberal with a meal, just your average ideal. I'm telling you this may seem sudden or strange. May not interest you much at all right now, but things change. Things change. Still, I'll understand if I'm not your kind of woman. Anyone can make one terrible mistake, and I've no special glamour. God, what a challenge. But I was determined to somehow pierce that, dedicated apathy. Now, I've found that no man, no matter his condition, can resist the charm of a growing boy. So I sent my son Theo to him.
Enter Theo. A lovable boy with his lovable dog.
Pippin, Pippin. Say hello to my duck.
How do you do?
Guess his name.
Augustus.
Wrong. His name's Otto. You're not very smart.
Smart enough to know that a duck belongs in a pond and not in my bed.
Bite me.
Pippin, what is the matter with you? You've been lying in bed for 7 days now.
It's nothing you could possibly understand.
Well, try me. Come on, give me a chance. Scoot over.
All right. I've been searching and searching for something fulfilling to do with my life. I've tried everything I could possibly think of. And I haven't come close. So I am in utter, abject, and complete despair.
Oh, that's it. Oh my God, I'm sorry.
Yes, that's it.
Pippin, let me tell you a little bit about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then, one day, he was struck by fever. And as his hand went cold in mine, I felt my life too was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days, but on the sixth day I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to run, a boy to raise. Pippin, this is such a large estate and I'm all alone here. I can't do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
Hold it! Hold it! You're supposed to read the line naggingly.
Yes, yes, I know, but he put his hand on my face.
I do not care where he put his hand. Read the line naggingly.
Okay.
Have you ever heard of social distancing? Back up.
Pippin! This is such a large estate, and I'm all alone here. I can't possibly do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
All right. I'm gonna shut you up.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working, and slowly he became a part of everything. Part of our everyday lives.
How often do we do this?
Every day.
Every day?
At first, Pippin didn't show much enthusiasm for the work. But as time went on, he showed no enthusiasm at all!
Keep up the good work, man. What? What are you looking at?
Oh, nothing. Oh, wait, Pippin. There was something. The roof on the chicken house is from a leak. If you can get to that by tomorrow, and the field needs plowing, and the chimney needs bricks, and the pigsty as well. Thank you.
I know that look. That's the look of a widow with a son and a large estate and no man to sit at the head of the table. But that's not me. You hear me? That's not me. Patching the roof and pitching the hay is not my idea of a perfect day. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. I'm not the type who loses sleep over the size of the compost heap. When you're extraordinary, you need to do extraordinary things. Each day the same, safe, insane, and swell. And when they told me he died, I didn't cry. All I could say was, how could they tell? Oh, looking at life from deep in a rut may give you a view of the sunshine, but it's so secondary to someone who is very extraordinary. And the chimney's in need of repair. If the garden has brambles and the yard is in shambles, well, I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care.
That's it. I'm leaving. I'm getting out of here.
But then, Theo Stuck got sick.
Pippin. Otto is sick.
That's about Theo. I'm sorry.
Pippin, it's the first time he's come to you for help.
Could you look at him, please?
Theo, I don't know anything about ducks.
Please, Pippin, try.
All right, let me have a look at him.
Now, say something hopeful.
This is a very sick duck. Theo, there's nothing I can do for him. Wait, Theo, come here. Come on the other night next to me.
It was like a painting. Man and boy and duck at prayer.
His breath has ebbed. His pulse is low. His feet are webbed, but even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we've kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't cursed our luck or run amok. Through prayer we've stuck. Please reward our
pluck
and save this duck.
They prayed all day. And then, just after sunset, the duck died.
Theo, I'm sorry. Hey, Theo, we can just go to the pond to get another duck. Why did the goddamn duck have to die?
But then, an interesting thing happened. See, Theo plunged himself into monumental despair while Pippin, the Prince of Despair, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirits.
Hey, Theo! We're going out to thresh some grain right now, and we need another good man. Another time, maybe.
But Pippin showed remarkable perseverance. When one way failed, he tried another.
Hey, Theo! Look what I made for you. Teach you to play if you'd like.
Well, most men would have given up, but Pippin, with remarkable persistence, tried yet another way.
Theo, you're not gonna believe what I got for you. Okay, when I count to three, you can turn around. One, two, three.
That's not a duck, dumbass.
Did I say it was a duck? Go on, you are flop.
Listen! I think we're gonna skip this part. Nothing much really happens here. A little bit of this, a little bit of this, and a whole lot of that. But the seasons change as they always do, filled with those everyday things to be done. Seeds to be sown, fences to be mended, and a love song to be sung.
Sitting on the floor and talking till dawn.
Candles and confidences,
trading old beliefs and humming old songs,
and lowering old fences,
singing a love song. La 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 la. Love song. La 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 la. Private little jokes and silly pet.
Lavender soaps and lotions,
all of the cliches and all of the games,
and all of the strings.
your eyes.
Why?
Because I've got a surprise for you.
I usually don't like surprises.
Well, you'll like this one, okay? Right here. Yep, just like that. Okay. You can look down. It's my quince pudding flambé. Oh, I haven't made it in years, but I thought that for this special occasion,
special occasion?
1 year ago today you arrived here, so, Theo and I thought we'd celebrate with a little party. I made you this, and Theo made you a new flute.
Thank you, Theo. I don't know what to say.
Well, let me say something then. In the year that you've been with us, a lot of water has flown under the dam, and you've come to mean a great...
Over the dam! Water flows over the dam.
Yes, I know. I just seem to be a little bit confused.
I can see that. Stick to the script.
I will. In the year that you've been with us, a lot of water has flown over the dam. And you've come to mean a great deal to me, to us, to our very ordinary lives. But I just want to say that for me and for Theo, we're glad you're here. And now we have so many good years ahead of us. Sit here, right at the head of the table. Well, isn't anybody going to eat my pudding?
I am.
Oh.
I can't stay here.
Pippin?
I'm sorry. I've got to go.
Why?
Because life has got to be more than ducks that die, and leaking roofs, and flaming quince pudding.
Are you sure?
I'm not going to be stuck doing the same damn thing every day.
At night?
Don't you see? I have to believe there's something more than this. There has to be.
What if there isn't anymore?
I know there is. Rivers belong where they can ramble.
I love my husband very much.
Eagles belong where they can fly.
The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life.
Got to be.
One day he was struck by fever. And as his hand
went
cold in mine, I felt my life too
much harder.
I was overcome by the deepest despair, and I just... Can you hold the music? Just for a second. Thank you. I guess I'll miss the man. Explain it if you can. His face was far from fine.
What are you doing?
But still I'll miss his face. And wonder if he's missing mine.
You don't have a song here!
I do now. Some days he wouldn't say a pleasant word all day. Some days he'd scowl and curse. But there were other days when he was really...
Don't think you should sing anymore.
Some men are heroes. Some men outshine the sun. Some men are simple good men. This man wasn't one. And I won't miss his moods, his gloomy solitudes, his blunt, abrasive style. But please don't get me wrong, he was the best to come along.
All right. What's next? What do I try next? Hello? Hello? Come on, you promised me there would be something. Something completely fulfilling. Is it there? Is it there? Come on, I have to believe there's something.
There is something, Pippin. And we've got it. The only completely perfect act in our repertoire. The finale!
The finale!
That's it? That's the finale?
Oh, no, Pippin. That was just the big build-up. You're the finale.
Me? Now?
Now. You will leap from the highest height into the hottest fire.
Become part of the fire.
Be engulfed by the fire.
Become the fire itself. And in that flame, you'll become a glorious synthesis of life and death.
And life again.
Wait a minute. You want me to jump and burn in fire?
Yes!
Pippin, you're an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams. You deserve an extraordinary climax.
Like the sun.
Blazing in the sky.
Like the sun at its zenith. Think about the sun. Pippin, think about her golden glance. How she lights the world up. Well, now it's your chance. With the guardians of splendor inviting you to dance. Pippin, think about the sun.
It
is time for you to do something truly extraordinary.
Think how you'll shine.
Like the glow of the morning.
You will burn in our memories forever.
Forever.
Think about your life, Pippin.
Days are tame and nights the same.
Now think about the beauty.
Think about the golden.
to me, please. I'm not a river or a giant bird that soars to the sea. And if I'm never tied to anything, I'll never be free.
What the hell are you doing out here? Come on, Pippin. Stop this nonsense. Get on with the finale, Pippin. The finale!
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. Never was there. I think it was here.
All right. You'll see what it's like without us. Take down the ladder. You heard me. Get it down here now. Get it out. All of it. And the curtains. Did I stutter? Get it out. And the chairs. Get all the chairs out. And the costumes. All of the costumes. All of the props. I swear to God, if I see another prop. Let's go. That isn't too flattering, is it, Pippin? Why have you not gotten their costume? What is wrong with you people? You amateurs! Silence! Get their costumes and their makeup and their wigs and get out of my face! Now! Look around, Pippin. How do things look to you now?
They showed me crimson, gold, and lavender. A shining parade.
A mole, Pippin! Look at the mole on her face! You got to spend the rest of your life with a woman with a mole!
But there's no color I can have on Earth that won't finally
fade. Hey, do you know how much it's gonna cost you?
When I wanted worlds to paint.
No lights, no magic!
And costumes to wear.
No costumes, no props!
I think it was here. Never was there.
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for the inability to bring you the finale we promised. It seems our extraordinary young man has elected to compromise his aspirations. But I know that there are many of you out there, extraordinary people, exceptional people, who would gladly trade their lives for the opportunity to perform one perfect act. And don't worry, we'll always be there anytime you need us. And we promise you sets, costumes, lights, and magic. All right, that's it. The show's over. You heard me. Let's go. I said let's go. Leave. Get off my stage. Go. Orchestra, pack up your instruments and leave. Take your damn hands off the keyboard, Joel. Try sing without music, sweetheart.
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. It never was there.
It always was here.
rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
Thank you. This magic moment.